Up, we have Auditya, which is a duo of badass Bangladeshi feminist performers, giving us a taste of what that radical vision of the future can look like. We have Zakia Afrin, and Zakia is a feminist lawyer who works with domestic violence survivors and a community-based activist who has taught me so much. And we have Aparna Kanungo, and Aparna is a storyteller and a performer who's passionate about putting women's stories into the world. And together, they're going to be sharing an excerpt from Sultana's Dream. And Sultana's Dream is a Bengali feminist utopian speculative fiction short story from 1905. Yes, 1905, 112 years ago. It was written by Begum Rokeya Shakabat Hosseini, who fought for the education of Bengali Muslim women at a time when women's choices were ridiculously constrained, at a time when patriarchy was at its height. And in the midst of that patriarchy, this is a story that envisions a world where the power hierarchies are reversed, and a story that has inspired, a story that has prefigured the work of generations of Bengali, of Bangladeshi women's movements. So please welcome up our storytellers.
What a beautiful day. But Sister Sarah, I'm feeling uncomfortable walking on the street in this broad daylight.
Come on, you are being mannish.
What is mannish?
You are shy and timid like men.
Is this a joke? Shy and timid like men? I feel awkward being a Pardanashin woman. I'm not used to walking unveiled like this.
You need not be afraid of coming across a man here. This is the ladyland, free from sin and harm. Virtue herself reigns here.
Where are the men?
In their proper places. They should be.
What do you mean by their proper places?
Oh, I see. You are new here. You don't know our custom. We shut our men indoors.
Just as we are kept in Zinana?
Exactly.
Oh my God, this is really funny.
But Sultana, how unfair it is to shut in the harmless women and let loose the men.
Why? It is not safe for us to come out of Zinana. We are so weak.
Yes, it is not safe for us as long as there are men in the streets. Just like when a wild animal enters a marketplace.
Of course not.
Suppose some lunatics escape from the asylum and begin to do all sorts of mischief to men, horses, and properties. What would you do with them?
They'll try to capture them and put them back to their asylum.
Thank you. And you do not think it is wise to keep sane people inside and let loose the insane?
Of course not.
In your country, this very thing is being done. Innocent women are shut up indoors. How can you trust those men outside?
Women don't really have a voice in these matters.
Why do you allow this to happen?
Because it can't be helped. Men are stronger.
A lion is stronger than a man, but it does not enable him to dominate the human race. You should not let the men do anything. Excuse me, they are fit for nothing. Only catch them and put them in the Zinana.
Would that be easy? To catch them and put them inside? How would we manage to work all day?
Do you think they work all day? No, Sultana, they do not. They dawdle away their time in smoking. They talk much about their work and do very little. Suppose one cigarette takes half hour to burn off and a man smokes 12 daily. Then you see he wastes 6 hours in sheer smoking.
How do you spend your time then?
I finish my work in the laboratory in just 2 hours. Then it's free time for needlework and cooking with solar heat.
Solar heat? How did you manage to collect solar heat?
Let me tell you a bit of our history. 30 years ago, our queen inherited the throne. She was only 13 years old. Our good queen liked science very much. She ordered that all the women in the countryside be educated. Education spread far and wide among women. Early marriages were stopped. In a few years, we had separate universities where no men were admitted. Women invented ways to collect solar power and water from the atmosphere.
Your achievements are very wonderful indeed. But tell me, how you managed to put the men in your country into the zinana? Did you entrap them first?
No.
It is not likely that they would surrender their free and open-air life of their own accord and confine themselves within the four walls of zinana. They must have been overpowered.
Yes, they have been.
By whom? By some lady warriors, I suppose.
No, not by arms.
Yes, it cannot be so. Men's arms are stronger than women's.
Then? By brain power.
Even their brains are bigger and heavier than women's, are they not?
But what of that? An elephant has a bigger and heavier brain than a man. Yet, men can enchain elephants and employ them according to their wishes.
Well said. But tell me, please, how it all actually happened. I'm dying to know it.
10 years ago, the neighboring country declared war against us. All the men went to fight. The enemy, however, was very strong. Our soldiers fought bravely, no doubt. But in spite of all the bravery, the foreign army advanced step by step to invade our country. The queen approached the women and asked us to use our brain power. The queen asked all the men to enter Zinana for the sake of honor and liberty. Wounded and tired as they were, they took the order rather for a boon. They bowed low and entered the zinanas without uttering a single word of protest. They were sure there was no hope for this country at all. Once our men were in, we used the solar heat against the enemy. They ran away panic-stricken, not knowing how to counteract that scorching heat.
And since then, your countrymen never tried to come out of the zinana?
Yes, they wanted to be free. Her Royal Highness sent them a letter mentioning that if their services should ever be needed, they would be sent for. And in the meantime, they should remain where they are. We call the system Mardana instead of Zinana.
How my friends at home will be amused and amazed when I go back and tell them that in the far off Ladyland, ladies rule over the country and control all social matters, while gentlemen are kept in mardanas to do all sorts of domestic work, and cooking is so easy a thing that is simply a pleasure to cook. May I ask, what is your religion?
Our religion is based on love and truth. It is our religious duty to love one another and to be absolutely truthful. If any person lies, he or she is
punished with death?
No, not with death. We do not take pleasure in killing a creature of God, especially a human being. The liar is asked to leave this land for good and never to come back.
I sure love this land. Thank you.